Hello students, welcome you all to this online class of Science with me. My name is Abhishek and it's Abhishek sir and you are watching the channel Vigyanam. In our part 1 of this chapter, that is the weather, climate and adaptations of animals, we had already completed about the weather and the climate, that how we can measure the weather, what are the elements of the weathers, and how we can calculate the climatic conditions of a particular place, right? Now it is the time to know more about the adaptations. Means we had already familiar with the weather and climate. So now it comes to the particular animals who is going to live on a particular place. So first of all, in this chapter, we will complete the two such regions, such as the polar region as well as the tropical region. So when we come to the places about the polar region, so there are some well-known countries which are comes under those polar regions, such as Canada, Greenland, Iceland, Norway, Sweden, Finland, Alaska in USA, and Siberian regions of the Russia. So these are the countries which falls under the polar regions, right? On other hand, so those countries which falls under the tropical regions, they are comes under such as India. Our India comes under the tropical rainforest region, such as Malaysia, Indonesia, Brazil, Republic of Congo, Kenya, Uganda, and Nigeria. So these are some of the countries which falls under the polar tropical regions. Now come to the focus on the polar region. So when we will focus on the polar region, what are the two animals that comes in our mind? One is that white fur lion, right? Or the white fur bear, which we say is a polar bear. On other hand, we can say the penguin, right? So why not we focus this on that polar bear and penguin? So when we come to the polar regions, it is a very cold, harsh condition. Means the temperature almost drops up to minus 37 degrees Celsius. So you can imagine that these are such places where the sun rises for almost 6 months, and for another 6 months the sun does not rises at that place. And if we can see that the temperature there can drops almost minus 37 degrees Celsius. So how harsh condition these are, right? So in our Earth, if it is our Earth, and if the the sun rays are coming from here, and if the Earth is tilted, so you can easily understood that when we will find out that these are the regions on which the the rays fall on the Earth. So if the sun rays is coming out from here, and if the Earth is tilted like this, and if this is that particular country, so you can easily understood that how the sun rays falls for 6 months, and another for 6 months if it is completely dark. So for another 6 months the sun rays will not fall at that particular place, right or not? Yes. So from this we can understand that how harsh condition it is. So when we talk about the polar bears, so they have what? They have white fur. So how they can survive at this harsh condition? The polar bears have the white fur so that they are not easily visible to the snowy white background. You can easily understand that why they have the white fur. Also, this white fur protect them from the predators. Obviously, every other animals have its own predators. So the polar bears can protect themselves with the help of that white fur. It also protect themselves with a flowchart. We can easily understand that how the polar bear can easily survive, because as they have the white fur that is not easily visible to the snowy white background, right? Its predators and prey are unable to see them. Okay. Also, they have the very strong sense of smell. If they have the strong sense of smell, what that will help them? It will help them to bear and locate and catch its prey. Obviously, if they have the strong sense of smell, so that can easily catch, help them to locate and catch its prey. On other hand, it has the long curd and the sharp claws, right? If they have the long curds and long curved and the sharp claws, so that can help them to walk on ice very easily, right? As well as when they are going to have that white fur, that fat of skin, means they under the skin they have a very fat layer, thick layer of fat. So that fat insulates their body from the cold and keep them warm, right? And also they have the two thick layers of fur that will keep them warm in the cold weather. So with the help of this flowchart, you can easily understand that how polar bear can survive in such harsh condition. So similarly, we talk about the penguin. Penguins also have that the double layered cloth. They also have that white fur which protect them from this extremely harsh condition. Even when we talk about the swimming, means as you have heard that for almost 6 months the sun rises. So obviously when the sun rises, the temperature rises. So to keep themselves cool, what they do, they used to swim. So when they swim, they are a very good swimmer, right? They are a very good swimmer. So what helps them to swim very fast? Their large claws, right? Similarly, the penguins and the the polar bears, that they have the very thick claws, which helps them to make a good swimmer, right? And as the body of the penguin is a streamlined body, and you have also understood about the streamlined conditions, which you have read about the fish, right? The streamlined condition. So because of the streamlined body, they can easily walk. And if we talk about the penguin, so you can easily understand that how the penguins have that streamlined body here. Here it is the streamlined body. You can easily understood that how the penguins have the streamlined body, right? Yeah. That's why they can easily swim under the water, and which makes them a good swimmer. Other animals like the penguins and the polar bears, which used to live in that polar region, such as the many types of fishes, then musk oxen, then reindeers, foxes, seals, whales, and some kinds of birds. So when we say about the bird, So when we say about the birds, there are some kinds of birds which used to migrate from that particular place, because unlike the animals, the birds need a warmer condition to survive, because you can easily understand the bird feather is not such as thick, such like the other animals. So that's why they need what? They need a warmer condition. And to find a hospitable condition, they used to move from one place to another place, right? And that's why we can say, you also have heard that Siberian cranes used to migrate from Siberia to India every year, like the Bharatpur in Rajasthan and Sultanpur in Haryana. So why they used to migrate? Because their conditions, the skin conditions, or they do not have that kind of white or thick fur. That's why that harsh condition is not that hospitable conditions for them, and that's why they used to migrate. So if anyone asks that how they can easily migrate from, how they can understand that they are going to migrate from that particular place to India every year, there are some researches which says that the birds can migrate with the help of the magnetic field of the earth. As you all know that earth have its own magnetic field, that is the north and the south pole. Similarly, with that magnetic field, they can find their own directions, and that's why they can easily migrate from one place to another place, right? It is that particular part of your book, page number 74 in NCERT. You can easily read this and can understand it very well more about, right? Now come to the another the part, that is about the tropical rainforest. As we had already discussed many points about the polar regions, now it comes to the tropical rainforest. When we say about the tropical rainforest, in tropical rainforest, the average temperature during the whole year is almost 22 to 25 degrees Celsius. So you can easily understand. So if the average temperature is like this, so during very extreme, a colder month, the temperature do not goes below the 15 degrees Celsius. So how warmer the condition could be in the tropical rainforest? And as you all are living in India, so you can easily understand that that the places near the equator, because this all warmer condition was only because of what? Equator. And if the sun falls like this, and if it is the equator, And if India is like here, so obviously if you are living in Siliguri and some others are living in some other places, some others are living in some South India. So they must feel that warmer condition compared to the persons who are living at the higher hill regions, right? So obviously the tropical rainforest, where we can find out the tropical rainforest, we can find out the tropical rainforest in Western Ghat. Where does the Western Ghat situated? Western Ghats are situated at the western part of our country, like the that particular Mumbai or Maharashtra or the Kerala region. And when we are going to have the tropical rainforest in the eastern part, in eastern there we can find out them in Assam as well as in South Asia. Central America is also the place where we can find out the tropical rainforest, as well as the Central Africa, as you have already heard about those Nigeria and another the countries, right? So some animals, what are the names of such animals, such as some animals which are found in the tropical rainforest are the monkeys, apes, gorillas, then tigers, elephants, leopards, lizards, some kinds of birds and snake, etc. So if the numbers of animals in this place is very high and this place condition is such humid and hot climate, so you can easily understand that how they can compete with each other for food and shelters, right? So many animals are there which used to live on trees throughout their whole life. So if we consider the red-eyed frog, here we can see the pictures of the red-eyed frog. This red-eyed frog, you can easily see the picture of the red-eyed frog. It used to climb in the trees. So this large paws of them help them to climb in trees very well, right? Because if they come to the ground and if they are living in the ground, so they can easily be a prey, okay? So to protect themselves from the predator, they have to live on the trees. Similarly, on other hand, if we have seen the monkey, in the tropical rainforest, the monkeys have the long tail, okay? And this long tail helps them to grab the branches very easily. This long tail helps them to grab the branches very easily, and they can easily survive over the trees, right? On the trees, they can easily survive. If they will come to the ground, they can easily be a prey, okay? So we can easily understand that why they... because of the competition of the food, if they will live on the trees, they can easily eat such leaves, on other hand the seeds, the fruits, etc. So they can complete the competition of the food. Also their body structure helps them to survive on the trees, right? Similarly, if we talk about the bird toucan, okay, large toucan bird, as well as the long, means this toucan bird have what? They possesses a long and the large beak. This long and large beak helps them to reach to the fruit on the branches. Here we can see the pictures of the large toucan bird. So if they are sitting on a particular branch, so this their beak helps them to reach to that particular fruit, which is going to be hanged on a very, thin branch, right, which is not as acceptable of its weight. Means if they are going to sit on that branch, so that branch might get cracked, right? On other hand, here we can see the picture of the long-tailed macaw. These long-tailed macaws are also known as the beard ape. These do what? Their body structure is such like that they have that silver color white mane, okay? Here we can see that if we just focus on the picture of this long-tailed macaw, so their long tail helps them to grab the branches very easily, and their thick skin as well as their skin color helps them to camouflage from their predators. So you also know that what is the meaning of the camouflage. When they are going to protect themselves from the predator, they used to hide themselves, right? So that particular process is known as what? Camouflage. So because of the skin color, they can easily camouflage. Similarly, if we come to the Indian tropical rainforest, in Indian tropical rainforest, we can see that elephant is there, which can easily survive. So how the elephant can survive? The elephant have their large ears. These large ears of elephant can easily make them to sense a very small sound, means very little sound they can hear, as well as these large ears can keeps them cool in that hot condition, okay? And if you can see the trunk of this elephant, so this elephant uses their trunk as a nose to grab anything, to grab any fruits or the leaves, as well as their teeth help them to tear the branches of the tree, right? Here we can see the modified teeth of the elephant. So these teeth help them to help them to grab the branches of the trees, or we can say help them to tear the branches of the trees. So with this body structure, they can easily survive, and their larger height can easily reach them to the heighted foods which are located at the heights. So the ground animals cannot go to that height very easily where the elephant can. So you can easily understand that how these animals can live in such harsh and humid conditions such as the tropical rainforest as well as the polar region, right? So here I'm going to end this chapter. I hope that you have understood this chapter very well. So complete all your assignments. Stay safe, stay alert. God bless you all.